Hello, and welcome to the announcement for the student winners of the Mount Vernon Prize for Excellence in Civics and History in honor of Dr. Jennifer London. I'm Allison Wickens, Vice President for Education at George Washington's Mount Vernon, and I'm pleased to be joined today by Dr. London, whose vision made this prize possible, and Sadie Troy, our Manager for Student Learning, who's going to be interviewing our winners today. Since the 1860s, Mount Vernon has been committed to preserving this historic space, as well as the education of people around the world about George Washington's life, his leadership, and legacy. Mount Vernon is committed to supporting teachers and students in the classroom with our resources and expertise, but this prize allows us to do something entirely new. It really positions us to hear from students about why they think that Washington's biography is important and relevant to their lives. We're really thrilled to be able to offer this prize.
My husband and I have been great admirers for George Washington for many years. We felt that the Mount Vernon Prize for Excellence in Civics and History in honor of Dr. Jennifer London would be a great way to recognize the outstanding student work that demonstrates an understanding and the application of George Washington, his life, his legacy, and his leadership. We felt, given the incredibly important role that Washington played in our early American history and even our world history, that it was important to create a platform for students to appreciate all aspects of Washington. Without Washington, America would never have won its War of Independence. Washington was a catalyst for founding America. From the time he became president until the time of his death, Washington's focus was on a self-governing nation. Washington was British, and he fought for the British. Later, he fought against the British. This alone took a lot of courage and conviction and a willingness to accept the circumstances. Britain was ruled by a king. Washington helped to create a country governed for, by, and of the people. And this model ultimately shaped not only America, but the way countries around the world began to look at and change their own governments. Washington had a deep sense of duty, and that shaped the course of his life. Many times during the Revolutionary War and during his presidency, he really wanted to return to his beloved home at Mount Vernon, but instead he answered the call of duty. Then, of course, there is Washington's incredible leadership skills. Washington overcame overwhelming odds many times, only to emerge victorious. And this demonstrates his intelligence and his strategic and tactical skills. But his most important legacy, I believe, was during the times when he was tempted to take on absolute power. And this was presented a number of times. Twice during the Revolutionary War, Washington was granted virtually unlimited powers to maintain the war effort. He took on those responsibilities, but he returned them as soon as he could. And Washington was to step down from a second term as president. King George III questioned American painter Benjamin West about what Washington would do next, when West said that he believed Washington would return to his beloved Mount Vernon. The king explained, "If he does that, he will be the greatest man in the world." King George III got it right. Washington remains one of the greatest men in the world today and of great historical significance and worthy of historical study.
Thank you, Dr. London, for those inspiring words. I am beyond excited to be joined today by our two student winners for our 2020-2021 inaugural year for the award. My very first guest is Sapir Agha, our middle school recipient. Although he's now a rising freshman at Blacksburg High School in Blacksburg, Virginia, he's being honored for the essay he wrote as an eighth grader entitled Washington's Farewell Address, The Letter That Shaped the Nation. Sapir, welcome to the interview. Thank you so much for joining us today, and congratulations again on your award.
Thank you. I'm very honored to be here, and I'm very honored to be the first recipient for the award.
Well, it was a great essay. I know I mentioned the title of your paper, but do you want to tell me a little bit more about your thesis?
Yeah. My thesis states that Washington wrote many things in his farewell address for the people around him and for the people of that time. But the address has still been relevant throughout history, and it's relevant even today.
Now, in your paper, you talked about Washington being one of the most influential founding fathers. Can you elaborate for us on why you think he was so influential?
So I think that Washington was the most influential founding father, since he was in so many areas during the early years of the nation. He was not just a general during the Revolutionary War, but he was also a strong diplomat and the first president. He also set the precedent for the two-term limit, where you see every president up until Franklin Delano Roosevelt only staying in office for two terms, even though it wasn't law in all that time.
So after all of your research, what do you think are the farewell address's greatest impacts on American history?
I think one of the greatest impacts that the farewell address had is how Lincoln used it to unify the North and amend what the South was doing during the Revolutionary War. To quote Lincoln himself, could Washington himself speak, would he cast the blame of that sectionalism upon us who sustained his policy, or upon you who repudiate it? We respect that warning of Washington, and we commend it to you, together with his example, pointing to the right application of it.
Wow, that is a really awesome quote. And
another impact that I think is also very important is that it added a song to Hamilton, the play.
And one of the better, or one of the, well, they're all great, but it's a really powerful song too, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
Now, I'm wondering, what was your favorite fact that you learned throughout this process?
The most interesting fact, and my favorite one in my research, was how both the North and the South used Washington and his words against the other during the Civil War. Abraham Lincoln used it to unify the North and reprimand the South, where you had Confederate President Jim Davis choosing Washington's birthday to take his oath of office, and Washington on horseback even becoming the seal for the Confederacy.
Now, why do you think it's important for students to study history?
That's an excellent question. I think that through learning history, we can better understand today's situation, and we can use the lessons in history to build upon the future. For example, studying the pandemic helps us to, in the future, be more prepared and save many more lives in case something like this happens again.
Very well put, Sapere. Well, thank you again so much for joining us today, and congratulations on being our very first ever middle school recipients. Now, as we continue, I'm very excited and honored to introduce our next guest, our high school winner of our award, Eden Fisher. Eden Fisher is a high school student from Nevada High School in Nevada, Missouri. She's being honored for her work in advocating for her state legislature for educational reform that would benefit both student physical and mental health. Eden, it is such a pleasure to have you join me today.
Thank you. I'm really glad to be here. This is really exciting for me.
Let's have you start by telling me about the two bills that you advocated for.
Yeah, so the first bill that I did was during my junior year of high school, and it was regarding vaping and the use of electronic cigarettes on school property and the consequences that it brought. My classmates and I were worried about the rising number of students that were using electronic cigarettes in our school, and especially like my friends and people that we were close with that we saw doing this every day. So me and one other student, we talked to Patricia Pike, our state representative of our district, and she gave us the opportunity to literally change the law, and that was so cool for us to do. So that was the first one. The second one I just did a couple months ago, and it was on stress management training for teachers. We were worried about the students in our school because our age range really falls in the rising numbers of anxiety and depression, especially due to COVID-19 and being in lockdown and being in quarantine. Getting the help that we need now that we have access to that is really important. But our counseling center, they do a great job. They do a wonderful, they're great at their job, but it was just really hard to get into the counseling center because there were so many people that were needing help that after we went back to school.
I want to know, how did you research those issues that you testified for?
Yeah, so I had access to the research database through our community college, Crowder College. We also interviewed a lot of teachers, and we kind of got a feel for, you know, especially for vaping, what they were seeing, and then for stress management, how they think that they can help the students in their classroom. We talked to our principal and the assistant principal, because they're the ones for vaping that would, if they caught students, they would be taking them, and they just had, you know, boxes full of electronic cigarettes that we saw, and it was crazy. And we talked to the school nurse because she saw the health problems that we talked about when we testified. We talked a lot about the risks and the health problems, so we talked to the nurse a lot. We also talked to our counselors. Each grade has a different counselor, so we talked to each one of them and kind of got, you know, how many students are they seeing from each grade level. And we kind of talked to see how they would like to have a little stress relieved off of their casework.
It sounds like you were also not just using academic research, but firsthand interactions as well. And it actually falls in line with our next question of, how valuable do you think civic engagement is for students, even if they're not old enough to vote yet?
Understanding what goes on in our country and being able to form your own opinions and hold your own opinions is very important, especially in the times that we are now. My 4 years of high school was based on politics, whether it was like high school drama or actual politics that were going on in our state and in our country. Being able to have a civil conversation was really important, and it can get you really far in life. I love that I was given the opportunity before I could vote to go change laws at our state capitol and to testify over something that I believed in. Forming your own opinions also comes with making your voice heard, standing up for what you believe in, and anybody can do that no matter what age you are.
That's a great note to end on. Eden, thank you so much for joining me today and for all of the risks you took within your own community to better the environment for students. Congratulations again. And I do want to give just one more formal congratulations to our two winners, Eden Fisher and Sapir Aga, for their work during the 2020-2021 school year. Mount Vernon is so proud to have you both as our very first winners of this annual award.
Congratulations to both Eden and Sapir for this great honor. I'm thrilled to announce that nominations are already open for the 2022 prize. We'll be accepting nominations from students who are doing research, projects, and inspired by George Washington throughout the school year. So if you know anyone or you yourself are inspired by Washington and want to model his leadership skills in your community, be thinking about nominating, submitting that nomination. The prizes are $1,000 for middle school students and $5,000 for high school projects. And of course, we like to honor our teachers as well, and there's a cash prize for the teachers as well. Thank you for your attention today, and we look forward to being inspired by students' visions of George Washington throughout the year.